Next, it's my pleasure to introduce Representative Elizabeth-Esty, who is a vice chair of the Task Force on Gun Violence Prevention. She's been a great asset to our group. Elizabeth.
Thank you. Thank you, Congressman Dold. Your district in Chicago knows the scourge of inaction in this Congress. Thank you for joining us. To my good friend, the Chairman Mike Thompson, for your leadership. As a gun owner, a hunter, a veteran, and a grandfather, you are showing the way for what this country needs to do. You don't like that grandfather part? All right, you're showing us the way. You should be proud of being a grandfather. And to Gabby and to Mark, you stand every day as American heroes doing the extraordinary by calling us to do the ordinary common sense of passing a comprehensive background check bill as soon as possible. My name is Congresswoman Elizabeth-Esty, and I have the honor of representing the brave community of Newtown, Connecticut, which over 2 years ago was visited by a horrific tragedy in the killing of 26 innocent people, 20 of them school children in the Sandy Hook Elementary School. Since that horrific tragedy, there has been a growing chorus of families, of grandfathers and grandmothers, mothers and fathers and children across this great country for the Congress to take action. Today, we are joining together in a bipartisan, common sense coalition effort to call on the 114th Congress to expand background checks for all commercial gun sales. When I first came to Congress just over 2 years ago and delved into this issue of gun violence prevention, I met with a senior official from the Alcohol, Tobacco, and Firearms, from ATF, and he told me a story I will never forget. He said, imagine this, Elizabeth. He was explaining the importance of closing the background check loophole. He said, imagine this. You arrive at the airport, and you have a choice. You can choose to empty your pockets, take off your belt, and go through the full-body scanner, or you can walk right onto the plane. That's the system we have in background checks in this country. So imagine this. Ask yourself this. If you are a felon, if you are a domestic violence abuser, if you are dangerously mentally ill, why would you go to a federally licensed firearm dealer? Why would you go to the booth at a gun show where they're going to ask you background checks when you can